Times like this can bring families closer together and not pull them apart. But you know what it takes? The Spirit of God to bring your family closer together without power, without air, without money, without food. You want to know what keeps people from the Spirit of God? It's usually selfishness. When our eyes are on ourself and not on God, we can't, the Spirit's not in our camper. It's not in our home. It's not in our family. When we're selfish, it's just on us. See, when we are not in the Spirit, you want to know who needs to change? Everybody needs to change but us. He needs to change. She needs to change. I can't believe he did that. I can't believe she said that. Can you believe those neighbors, they got those logs on our yard? Can you believe they dug that trench? Can you believe they did this, their fence? Are they ever going to clean up after themselves? We just look at everything else. Everybody's the problem except, but a man or a woman in the Spirit says, Lord, change me. Lord, change me. Change my heart, Lord. Maybe I can help them. Maybe I can help them pick up those papers. Maybe I can help them pull those logs. Maybe I can go check on them, see if they're okay. Maybe they're dead over there. Maybe I can take them a meal. Maybe I can pray for them. Maybe, Lord, you're calling me to be part of the solution, not part of the problem. Another reason people never get to the Spirit is because of our selfishness. We just aren't really Christians. We have it here, but it's not in our heart. We're not in the Spirit. We have an intellectual agreement, but we're not full of the Holy Spirit. A Spirit-filled man and a Spirit-filled woman is not critical. Pointing out everybody else's faults, he's not that, she's not this. By the way, some of the most sensitive people I meet are the most critical people. What I would share with, sometimes we've got to let real love breathe. Everybody's not going to fit your mold. God created us all different. They're not going to talk the way you want them to talk. Everybody does dumb stuff. We're sinners. Facebook's going to have stupid things on it. People are going to have different ideas. People are going to express things that hurt you, offend you. But as believers in the Spirit of God and in the Spirit of the gospel of Jesus Christ, a man of God and a woman of God, real love, it says in 1 Corinthians 13, keeps no record of wrongs. It keeps on loving no matter what they post. It keeps on loving no matter what their yard looks like. It keeps on loving even if their fence has been down for 2 months. It keeps on loving. Because a man of God says, Lord, use me. A woman of God says, use me. The eyes are not on ourselves, it's on the Lord.